the Gaia theory sees the Earth as a self-regulating entity that keeps its climate and its chemical composition always at the best level for whatever happens to be the life that's on it at any given moment. And it's made up of the atmosphere, the oceans, and all of the surface rocks, and everything alive, including us. They're part of the regulation of the whole system, as are all the great ecosystems of the planet. Perhaps the most important of them are in the oceans. The oceans cover 70% of the Earth, and the life in the oceans does the most of the regulating. But the forests are very important, both the tropical and the boreal forests in Canada and Siberia. What we do as people in destroying forests, mainly to make farmland to feed ourselves, is of course cutting our own throats, because we depend on Gaia, on the Earth, to regulate the climate and keep it a comfortable place for us to live on. If we take away its parts, it's rather like cutting out your liver because you're hungry. It's a very foolish thing to do. We'll be in a real mess as this century advances. The number of people surviving to the end of this century may be as few as 1 billion. It's only 1/7 as many as there shortly will be. And it'll be mostly a consequence of the Earth changing, because what we are doing to it into scrub and desert. And the problem is not that you can't live in somewhere like the Australian outback, writ large over the planet, but it doesn't produce any food, and food has to come from somewhere, or people starve, and they will. I've a lot of time for Cool Earth as one of the more responsible charities for doing things which will help at least slow this process of degradation of the planet. It's much better to encourage people to look after their forests and begin to realize what they mean to the Earth and to everyone else alive than it is to cut them down and then even replant plantations. Humans cannot plant an ecosystem. They can plant a plantation, but that's not the same thing at all and doesn't do anything like as much good. If you wanted to really do something for the planet, forget about your carbon footprint and things like that. I doubt whether you'll be able to do anything significant, but there is a charity called Cool Earth that does really deserve support, because the money it spends will help native peoples look after the great ecosystems of the Earth where they live. And this, I think, is a really good cause. The best way to think about our place in the order of things in Gaia is that we represent a kind of evolutionary experiment. We've got enormous value to the planet because we're the first conscious, intelligent species it's ever had. And for the first time, our planet, Gaia, has seen itself from space and seen what a beautiful planet it is compared with the dull deserts of Mars or Venus. So I think we're both good and bad, and let's hope that evolution accentuates the good and eliminates the bad.